Welcome to Pavan Devarakonda channel. In this session, we are going to learn about the Ansible Automations DevOps Centers. Let's see cron job. Cron tab is a command in Linux. We can see the help, and if you can see the list of cron jobs using the -l option. Let us jump deeper into this topic and let us see what it is going to do. Ansible documentation is providing wonderful examples, and here are some parameters also makes us very easy to manage. The cron D or cron tab entries very, very easy to handle them in our remote missions. So you can modify, you can add, you can delete anytime these cron jobs on a remote missions. So that's the best option which we can have here. So minute by minute you can update, or you want to make the job run every second, or if you want to run every certain seconds or certain minutes, certain hours, or by one particular user. These are all different options we have in the parameters list, one after the other. If you look at the description of every parameters, you can understand each one. And let us explore more about this and understand clearly and use them, each parameter, into our playbook. So I have a simple file that is going to generated by the Ansible playbook that is going to have a simple shell script, and we can get it. That is from the DevOps Hunter, and you can have that copy module helps us to create the simple shell script. So in this documentation here, we can see the more and more parameters, how to use, how to apply, how to each task is having the name, and you can understand the purpose of that particular task, and you can use any one of the task and into you copy that into your playbook and apply according to your system, your project needs. So when you want to run, when that particular job, that is the main important thing which we can automate without manual intervention. It is automatically executed by the system, by the Ansible. It is going to place into the remote systems, and also we can remove that particular cron job. Whenever it is creating the cron job, it is going to place hash Ansible handled cron job. So let us begin, and in this file we are going to add that task cron job, adding, creating. That is the main purpose here. 10th line onwards, we can add a new task. Under task, this is a second task, right? So insert, and we can add the name for the task. So the name is create cron job. That's a main aim for this one. And then the module name is cron. So we can use either fully qualified community name, or we can use simple short form or alias name cron module. After that, two spaces in the next line, then we can give the different parameters name. So this name is a parameter, it's not a name of the that particular task. So it doesn't require the hyphen, remember that point here. So in the examples, wherever you see the after the cron module, you can see the name which is mentioned without hyphen. That is an important thing to observe here. So parameters we can add, each parameter under this name we can add. So time we can control with the different values, minutes, hours, days, weekdays, etc. So let's see, first one we can mention as minutes. So if you are going to say every minute you want to execute, then star. If you want to give some specific number, then that will be executed every 2 minutes, every 5 minutes, like that. You can also mention hours, hour. So which hour you want to execute this one? You want to execute every hour, then you can mention star. And you want to execute at 2 o'clock, then you can simply say that 2. So 2 a.m. it is going to execute if you mention that one. And remember that point, every time you are going to place this and included in double quotes. Remember that point. All the cron values, what you are going to mention, each one will be added to the cron job on the remote machine. So if you target in the local machine, it will be executed on the local. If you target on the remote machine, it will work on the remote machine, the cron job creation. So this is creation, and similarly, you can also work on the remote removal of any cron job. That is also possible. So this is the most common requirement. Sometimes you need to modify the existing cron jobs. That is frequent changes required for the database related backups, or if you are working on the frequent or you are maintaining some bigger systems and you want to control them from the Ansible controller, this is the best choice which we can use. So weekdays is also one of the different choice. We can see here, weekdays 2 means 0 Sunday, 1 means Monday, 2 means Tuesday. So weekdays 2, if you are mentioning every Tuesday, it is going to execute this particular cron job. All right, let's come back to our script. We can also add month. So every month you want to run, then you can mention the star month, or you can mention every quarter you want to mention, then you can add those with the comma separated. So that is also a choice we have. And we can mention the numbers as well. So 1 to 12 is numbers which we can use in the month. After this root, we can add as a user. So you can also use a different user, not compulsory to use the root. So cron job can be executed from other users which are having the sudo or access. All right, then we can also look for the next parameters which are compulsory to work. That is the, what job you want to execute with the cron job. That is a script, or that is one process which you want to run. So job here, I want to run this particular script which is present in the temp folder, hello.sh. So just for example, we are using this one, but actually it is going to create that particular hello.sh in the temp folder on the remote machine, and it is going to set this. Otherwise, what happens? The file is not existing. You are going to get in the whenever it is going to execute that. So when we run this Ansible playbook and cronjob.yaml, it is going to be executed in target machine. So here I'm using the target machine as a local machine. You can use remote machines, and n number of machines we can run. So a simple execution. So you can see here the job is changed. The change is indicates that the cron job is created successfully. We can check this cron job created on simple command. Sudo cron tab -l will shows that particular entry is happened or not. We can check that one with the hyphen -l. So sudo cron tab -l, that will gives the entry what we have created in the playbook. So that's all for now in this learning session. So hope you understood how we can add a cron entry using the Ansible playbook. You can modify, you can add, you can delete anything you can make with this Ansible. So hope you like this, and if you like, you can share it with your friends, and I wish you can